Now I move to the theory that is called Ganon theory. See this theory. You can see the second image of this area, the Hippocrates four humors. Actually, this theory starts from the Hippocrates period only. But the logic, see this case, this Hippocrates four humors, and this was the Aristotle four sources. Next one is the Galen. I'm using the different color to highlight it. Yeah. So this was the Galen's four temperament. This is for the Paracelsus four temperament. Then Atticus, then Atlas. Like this, most of the psychologists know, they're dividing the people's personality into four. And the basic thing is started from the Hippocrates period. So he divided the people based on the four humors or facial reactions. He coined the term as a blood and yellow pile and black pile and mucus. So for this, each there is a, some kind of temperament also is blended with. So those who are having the those who are classified in the blood category, they have some kind of characteristics, some kind of temperament that he pointed out. And also parallelly, he's linking with the persons with some kind of seasons, like a spring season is called blood, then yellow pile is called summer season, black pile for the autumn season, then mucus for the winter season. So this is the origin, this theory is the origin from the Hippocrates one. But after this, then Galen, he did the same kind of theory in the year 119 AD. And this theory is talking about the sanguine, choleric, melancholic and phlegmatic. So the terms only differ. See, the terms only differ in this case, but he's also divided people based on the four seasons or based on the four phase reactions. That thing's only focusing. So those who are having, according to the Hippocrates, the blood represent that's called happy nature people. Those who are having good face reactions, happy face reaction, or always some people having the smiley face reaction. No? That people may come to the blood. According to the Galen, it's called as a sanguine. In the case of yellow bile, they treated as a summer. So like those who are very much angry, whenever you see some people, you know, always you can see some kind of angriness in their faces. That people, according to the Galen, is called choleric. The next classification, according to the Hippocrates, is called black pipe. But for him, the Galen, he classified the people's name as a melancholic. What is melancholic in the sense? There's atoms. So autumn represents black. Already you know the importance of the color. Even some of the colors is represent some of the feelings as well as the some of the things it may intimating. If you look onto the color of black, we can easily to understand that there's a color for the sadness. If you see the color of green, we can easily understand it's like ready. It's talking about the positive responses that green color represent. In the case of the yellow, represents a ready for this. Some of the color is representing some kind of notions or some kind of things is representing. The same manner, the black is represents sad. So, but according to the Hippocrates, he compared with that kind of people is called some kind of seasonable, it's called autumn. And according to the Galen, he coined the term as a melancholic. It means that some people, the face reaction always sad faced. So you could not see the happiness or you could not see the angry faces and all. Even we could not predict what kind of face reaction is showing to us. That kind of face reactions, that's called as a melancholic. So most of the time, some kind of sad kind of face reaction only being shown to us. That's called as a melancholic. The next one is called phlegmatic. So in this case, the winter, so according to the Hippocrates, he mingled with winter seasons. It means what is the facial reactions of the winter seasons people having in the sense that people are very lazy. They you cannot see the active things from the facial reactions, like sleepy nature. So whenever you see some people, you also feel to go for sleeping. That kind of facial reaction some people may get. So that people may call as phlegmatic. Why I'm using the term as a four temperament here in the sense, most of the psychologists, they divide the people's of the people's personality into four classifications. That's why I use the term as a four temperament. But now I'm focusing only the Galen theory. But the origins of the theory started from the Hippocrates only. That is why I'm using the three terms together. And it started from the 400 BC to 1978. This much of psychology, they're discussing about this kind of four types of the personality. So we will discuss one by one. Yes. So you are finding the two persons. This is a person, it's called Hippocrates. In the case of 400 BC, this is Galen's and 190 AD. So this is a time period for them. And both of them, the contribution looks like is same in the course of the personality, because he's also divided the people's personality four based on the seasons. He's also divided the people's into four classifications based on the seasons as well as the facial reactions of the people. Now see, even some of the proverbs, it's made by the Hippocrates. It's somewhat very powerful meaning. It's linked with his personality theory also. See, this key is, according to him, our food is our medicine. Apparently, our medicine should be our food. So it means you can take a proper food. So if you are taking a good food, you don't need for the any medicines. So this is his prediction, so his idea also. That is why he suggests, made some kind of verse like our food should be our medicines and our medicine should be our food. So from this we can easily to come for one conclusion that if anything should be excess or somewhat less in the sense, it is opposed to the nature. Because if your body is normal, this is no problem. If your body is having any issue, you feel some kind of excessing things or some kind of deficient things. So according to him, the excess thing as well as the deficient thing is not good for in the case of the health as well as the any kind. Even the facial reactions, if you are having the less happy, if you don't have that much of swimly face, you have some kind of psychological disorder. Some people are having the more facial reactions and always the smiley nature and that also some kind of personality disorder according to him. That's why he highlights some technical verb proverb. Everything is excess or deficit is opposed to the nature. Everything should be normal. So according to him, if ever something is to be excess, there is a problem for him. If something is deficient, there is a problem for him according to him. So this also said by the Hippocrates only. And these are classifications made by the Galen. Actually, Galen used temperament to refer to bodily dispositions. Disposition determine the person's susceptibility to certain diseases. The overall concept of the Galen's theory is that each type is believed due to the surplus. I already mentioned that if you excess or deficient, there is a problem in the psychological basis. So due to the surplus of one of the bodily fluids in which is in agreement to the character. So here the surplus as well the deficits is replicate the characters of the persons. And this theory used to accomplish to medical theories. Some of the medical theories also, they consider this theory is the origins of the theory for the psychological disorder or not. And if your humors and temperament are in balance, this term is important. If your humors or the temperament are in balance, it means that we are or you are healthy people. If that humors and temperament is not balanced, we have some kind of problem is there. And Galen believed that if there was an excess or deficit of one of the humors, it is caused by disease and disability. Sometimes it leads to disability also. Deficits can be caused by the vapors that were taken in by the body only. So this kind of theory, this is a basic of the Galen theory approaches. And he divide the people's personality into the four. One is called choleric, melancholic, and sanguine. And he inspire with there is a four elements of our Panchabhuta. That's, he knows our Panchabhuta. The Gans inspire came from the four elements, which include fire, earth, water, and air. So this is the four basic elements based only he developed the theory. As well as the some of the ancient Greek medicines and philosophy also, they follow the same kind of elements only. Then Garen associated the four temperaments to humans. So he linked with this kind of fire, earth, water, and air with some temperament which humans do. The temperament include, instead of using the fire, earth, and water, he's using the temperament names like warm, cold nature, moist, or dry nature. Like that, convert the fire, earth, water, and air into the temperament based like warm, cold, moist, and dry. And the combination, there is a combination also may comes like a compo. See this case, there is a compo between the hot and dry. So if you go with hot and dry compo, so what it means, hot is also very hot, okay, and dry is also dry. So if you go with hot with dry, the color may be yellow. That people personality's color is chloric. So these people always having some kind of angry expression in their face. Therefore, that is called chloric. Even you can see the nature, hot and dry. This is also negative. In the case of seasonable seasons, is called hot seasons. We won't feel like a summer season. We don't like much. The same error, dry also we don't like. So if you compare these two things, it leads the chloric. This chloric represent agreeable characteristics, and the other compo, dry and cold. See, one case is dry, one is negative. That cold is somewhat is good, but apparently not that much of good. Okay, so if you are blending with dry and cold, we are getting the color according to the theory. They use the term as a black pie. That people is called melancholic. So melancholic people. So what is black represents sad. So those who are having the facial expression of sad and cry, that may come under the melancholic. So melancholic people's they won't much active, but their facial reactions you may feel like sad characteristics only. The other compo, wet and cold. So see this positive to the wet. So in the case of wet, wet feel, and cold, both are in a cold nature only. If you use the wet and cold combination, we are getting the blue color. So normally in the case of the winter seasons, what we are doing in the month of December or so for Tamil Nadu, the winter season in the month of January as well as the December. So that time is a very cold nature. That's why the people's not much active. Like always they feel some kind of sleeping face reactions on. So they combine into the two compo terms, a phlegmatic. The represent of the term is water because the color is also a black color. So not blue color, so water color, you know the color of the sea is green, blue color. The same things they represent here. The phlegmatic represent the characteristics, those are having the facial reactions of the sleepy natures. That is called as a phlegmatic. That people not much active and they won't be involved much in any kind of things and all. And the last one that is called hot. See this case, one side is hot, one side is a wet. So it's like a balanced personality. One side hot, other one is a wet. So some kind of balanced things may come. Therefore, they use the term as a blend in this case. They use this the element as a air in this case. So here the sanguine is nothing but those are having the facial reaction of smile. So always, whenever you see some people, we are feeling some kind of good facial reaction, like the smiley facial reaction, smiling facial reactions. That people is called as a sanguine. So I hope now you understand the Galen's contributions in the psychology theory. He associated in the four temperament to homos, and he made into combination of two things, and finally he combined the compo into some kind of technical terms. So the compo warm and cold, the compo between the seasons is called warm and moist, or warm and dry, or cold and dry, as well as the cold and moist. So all this kind of compo, hot or dry, or dry or cold or wet. are better with oil. This kind of combo heat coin. And the coin combo is called as a sanguine, choleric, melancholic and phlegmatic. A temperament, I already mentioned that there is a term we use in the last time also, the temperament. The temperament is also like a combo term only. It's a combo of the physical, emotional as well as the mental characteristics. So these are the three combination only is called as a temperament. Normally, in the case of the sanguine people having the optimistic characteristics, see, I'm going to be highlight this one. So, yes, a network issue. I'm going to close the camera. Yeah, temperament is a combo of the physical, emotional, and mental characteristics of the person. This I already mentioned. Gallium inspiring came from the four elements, which include fire, earth, water, and air. So, these are the four combinations he converted to a temperament. Includes warm, cold, moist, or dry. So there is a four panchabhuta, not only five panchabhuta, but he left one. Only he taking the considerations of only the four. Based on the four, he make it some kind of temperament logic. One is for warm, cold, moist, and dry. Yeah. So now I'm moving to the temperament which he divided by the gallons. The first one is called sanguine. I already mentioned that sanguine is a combination of hot and wet combo. So the color represent blood, the seasons represent air. Okay, so here the characteristics of the people based on the facial reaction, based on the temperament, they are the optimistic leader, light-hearted people, optimist, happy, hopeful, and accommodations. These are the characteristics for them. It is corresponding trait is openness to the experience. They always having the broad thoughts to get into the get all any kind of feedback. They are having the openness mind to adopt anything. That kind of openness the sanguine people have it. That's why I'm using the word sanguine is the optimistic. It is fluid, is blood. See the case of the her facial reactions of this child. Now the phlegmatic. In the case of phlegmatic, it's calm. Calm nature people, they make come under this. There is a combo for the phlegmatic. The phlegmatic combo is called wet and cold. That combinations only it leads the phlegmatic. So what it's represent in the sense, these people having a relaxed mindset, they're very peaceful and a very cold nature. So even if you're keeping some crackers or a bomb also, they won't run away from this. So they may very slowly walk. They are not much active. So that's why I use the term as a slow and sluggish people, very lazy people, this kind of people. And the third people is called choleric. The combo of the choleric people is hot and dry. These two compounds made the choleric. So from this, you can easily understand her facial reaction that the child. Very angry, very aggressive characteristics. Normally, the choleric is called irritable. It is bodily fluid, it's yellow pipe. It is corresponding trait is agreeableness or aggressiveness. That's why I use the term irritable, angry, strong and active imagination. But apparently, they may take a very strong decisions, but apparently they have some kind of good imagination power also. The last one is melancholic. So this a combo is happened because of the two things. One is called dry and cold. So the dry and cold combinations may lead to the melancholic. So the melancholic people, they have these sad characteristics. Always they crying. They won't having the broad visions. They are very pessimistic. They always thinking the negative things only. They are very analytical and quiet. They are very depressed. Sometimes they won't mingle with other visitors also. The sad always in the phase reactions, we can find out from the sad characteristics. These people may come with the name is called melancholic. The color for them is a black pipe. And apparently, he combined the humors into corresponding to the four weathers. The same things only Hippocrates also told. The Hippocrates also, he combined the people's things with the four weather seasons. Here, the sanguine correspondence with spring. The spring season is called as the sanguine. So, normally the spring season, we are enjoying a lot. So, in this case of the facial reactions, the smiley things, then the choleric corresponded to summer. So now we know how we are fed up with the summer season or not. So the choleric is a irritable, some kind of aggressive people, they meet it as a choleric for some of the people. Then the melancholic, they correspond with autumn. So the autumn represents, it is a in between these seasons of the summer to winter. That period will limit it as an autumn. These people, they feel as a very sad, that kind of face reactions. So the term, the color which you use for the melancholic is black color. The lockstone is a phlegmatic. These people, the blue color represents the phlegmatic. The correspondence with winter. So during the winter, how we are reacting. So, the phlegmatic people, the nature of the phlegmatic people, cold, calm, and slow, and sluggish, and indifferent. So this kind of nature, they always, they're having some kind of sleepy facial reactions. This is a theory made by the Galen. I hope now you understand the theories of the Galen. The Galens divide the people's personality into four, based on the temperament as of the physical reactions. That's why, but apparently he inspired with the four elements. From the four elements combination only, he coined this kind of particular theory. The four elements, fire, earth, and water, air. In the case of the temperament, he convert this fire, earth, water, and air into warm, cold, moist, station, and dry. These four terms, there's a two compo. That compo, one is called, sanguine, choleric, and melancholic, and phlegmatic. The compo made between the two, one is warm and moist, and warm and dry, and cold and dry, as well as cold and moist. So for this only, he made this kind of theory. And the same thing you can see from this diagram also, hot, wet, and cold and dry. There is a compo, hot and dry, yellow fire. So I'm showing you once again, this is called yellow fire. This is seasons called summer. This diagram is more enough to understand the entire theory. So these periods, according to him, they use the term as a manhood periods. The people's need it as a summer. And dry and cold. If the combination of dry and cold is a black fire. This is earth. This period is called autumn. When it happened in the old age. In the case of blood, how it happened in the compo between the hot and wet, this is seasons called spring. The child durations of the people for childhood period. Then the last compo, wet and cold. That compo is the blue color, phlegmatic, that represents the water. So this is why he combined the term, and this is represent the winter. And these people is called decrepitude. So in this manner, it's divided. And apparently, if you see the Carl Jung theory, we can easily to classify the introvert extrovert also with this. See the case of introvert characteristics. And these are the introvert characteristics. These are the extroverted characteristics. But those who are extroverted, choleric, they have this kind of characteristics. Those who are extroverted, those who are sanguine, they have this kind of characteristics. Those who are having the phlegmatic, but they are introverted, they have this much characteristics. Those are melancholic. They are introverted in the sense, they have this much of characteristics, assemblage may be there, according to the Eisenach. This is commonly the type come trait approach that we discuss later. So because this theory is only talking about the sanguine, phlegmatic, choleric, and melancholic only. Yeah, so once again, I'm showing the classic fourfold typology. This is said by the Kant. See why I'm using the term. This is an image I get it from the online sources. Kant 1798. See this case, just I'm showing the first image which I'm showing to you from this. You can use it to understand what is the fourth chloric. See here, this much of people are contributing for developing the four temperament based classification. One of these is called Kant. So the Kant. He is the psychologist after the Hippocrates as well as the Galen. That's why I'm using the term after Hippocrates and Galen. He is also mentioned the four kinds of personality, melancholic, phlegmatic, choleric, as well as the sanguine, based on the seasons. And he's keeping, he combined with the people's personality with some season also. The sanguine people, these are the catastrophe-able, easy-going, sociable, carefree, hopeful, contented. So this is an smiley people having the facial reaction. They have this kind of natures. The melancholic people, so that people is having the facial reactions of the cry, sad and all. They're having the facial reaction. They're having the personality characteristics like this. Then phlegmatic people, those are having the facial reactions of the sleepy nature, sleepy. That people is called phlegmatic. The characteristics reasonable, hygiene, principled and controlled, persistent, calm and all. Then finally choleric. These people are very adamant, very angry, catastrophic face reaction these people having. So hopefully you understand the theories.